We discussed about the polynomials, division algorithm, factor theorem, remainder theorem, synthetic division of polynomials, and related to the polynomial equations, just we established the relation between the roots and the coefficients of the polynomial equation or polynomial in the previous class. Now, for suppose I have a polynomial, or if it is equals to 0, it is a polynomial equation. So, an x power n and so on, it is an nth degree polynomial. Since it is an nth degree polynomial, as we discussed, by fundamental theorem, it has n roots, so mention them as alpha 1, alpha 2 and so on, alpha n. These are n roots and this is the polynomial. So what you say about this sum of the roots? So sum of the roots of the polynomial is simply minus a n minus 1 by a n. Okay, as well, product of the roots is minus 1 to the power n into the constant term divided by the leading coefficient. Okay, this is sum of roots and this is the product of the roots. Now what I am going to decide is, nature of roots I am going to decide. So basically in quadratic itself we discussed about different aspects related to the nature of root as well. So in the same way now we are discussing for this polynomial equation. First suppose you just look there, the coefficients. So coefficients in the sense all these a n minus 1 and so on, a0. For suppose if all these coefficients are rational numbers, all these coefficients are rational numbers and one root, it has n roots, right? Any one root is of the format some alpha plus root beta. Okay, or you may say anything, because I have alpha plus root beta. See, the coefficients are all rational numbers and one root is alpha plus root beta, then what you say about the other root? As I said, the coefficients are rational numbers, right? And one root is alpha plus root beta, right? Then I am going to analyze the roots. In this situation, I am going to analyze the roots. This is all the given task. Now, what I will conclude is, since all these coefficients are rational numbers, what you say about this sum of the roots? Sum of the roots is minus a n minus 1 by a n, right? All these coefficients are rationals. A n minus 1 is rational. A n is rational. Okay. So, sum of the roots is clearly rational. See, since sum of the roots is rational, okay. So, sum of the roots is rational. As well, all these coefficients are rational. A0 is rational. A n is rational. A0 by a n is rational. Product of the roots is also rational. With that particular information, it is very clear that this sum and product both will belong to the rational numbers. And now, think about this alpha 1, alpha 2 and so on. Since one root is alpha plus root beta, one among these n numbers is alpha plus root beta, sum of all these numbers is rational numbers, and so, since one among them is alpha plus root beta, then sure, what will happen to the other? See, since one among them is alpha plus root beta, this root beta is not a rational number, this root beta is irrational number. To maintain this sum as a rational number, for sure, any other root is also of the form alpha minus root beta. That's my conclusion actually. Coefficients rationals and one root is alpha plus root beta. This is my analyzation. From there, what I will conclude is, any other root, one of the other root is alpha minus root beta. Just think about it. One root is alpha plus root beta. So I don't have any other root of the format alpha minus root beta. Then how can I get the sum as well the product both as rational numbers? It's not possible, okay? So if one root is alpha plus root beta, and another root is alpha minus root beta, then only the sum of all these numbers will become a rational number. Okay, so just I am saying that if one root among these is alpha plus, actually it has n roots, right? One root among them is alpha plus root beta, then for sure any other root is of the form alpha minus root beta. In another way, I conclude that if the coefficients are rationals, alpha plus root beta and alpha minus root beta occurs together, okay? Since the coefficients are rational, and then I will conclude that alpha plus root beta and alpha minus root beta occurs together. Occurs as roots together. Both will occur as together. Okay. If one will happen, then the other thing for sure will happen.
Already we discussed in quadratic also. If the coefficients of a quadratic equation are rational numbers and one root is some 2 plus root 3, then for sure we conclude that the other root is 2 minus root 3, right? The same thing we are extending for the polynomials, okay? Just have a look. From there, see, it is very clear for all of us that if the coefficients are rationals and one root is some of the format alpha plus root beta, then directly we will say that the other root is alpha minus root beta, right? Just have a look. I will give you another idea. Just look at the board for the next point. See, now this time, if the coefficients are all real numbers, see, in the previous point, all the coefficients are rationals. If the coefficients are all real numbers and one root is of imaginary complex format alpha plus I beta, all the coefficients are reals and one root is alpha plus I beta, then what you say about the other? See, since this is already clear that all the coefficients are reals, so real number by real number is real, so sum of the roots is real. Real number by real number is real, so product is also real. So sum and product, both of these belongs to the real numbers. Now just think about it. Sum of all these n numbers is real, product of all these n numbers is real. Among these n numbers, one number is alpha plus I beta. Since one number is alpha plus I beta, to get sum as real, for sure you need to maintain minus I beta. As well, since the product is real, since one is alpha plus I beta, to maintain it for sure we need alpha minus I beta. So as a conclusion, what I conclude is, if one root is alpha plus I beta and the coefficients are reals, then to maintain sum and product as reals, for sure you will get one of the other root is of the format alpha minus I beta. Okay, just because to maintain the sum and product as reals, right? So since one root is alpha plus I beta, other root is alpha minus I beta, therefore we conclude that again alpha plus I beta and alpha minus I beta occurs as roots together. If one will happen, then for sure the other will happen. Occurs as roots together. Okay, just have a look. This is the second point. Based on this, now I will give you some simple problems. So till now we discussed that if the coefficients are rational numbers, then alpha plus root beta and alpha minus root beta occurs together. And as well, if the coefficients of reals, alpha plus I beta and alpha minus I beta occurs together. Then now, if P of x is a polynomial over real numbers, since it is over real numbers and one root is 2 plus 3i, then what to say about the other root? See, I don't know about the degree of the polynomial. It may be of any degree. Okay, the polynomial may have any number of roots as per the degree, but since one root is 2 plus 3i and this polynomial is over reals, then for sure I will get another root as 2 minus 3i. And here you need to understand the word that polynomial over reals. See, if I say polynomial over reals, then it represents that all these coefficients, the coefficients of the polynomial, an minus 1 and so on, a naught, all these numbers are reals. Okay? So if all the coefficients are reals, then the polynomial is mentioned as polynomial over R, polynomial over reals. So if one root is 2 plus 3i and the other root is 2 minus 3i, there is the situation. Now coming to another bit. Now here they mentioned that polynomial is over Q. Over Q in the sense polynomial is over rationals. That means all the coefficients of the polynomial are rationals. Since all the coefficients of the polynomial are rationals and the roots are given in such a way, minus 1, 3, 4 plus root y, minus 1, minus root 2 are the roots of the polynomial. Since it is polynomial over rationals, one thing is very clear that, see, these two are rational numbers, no problem. Since 4 plus root 5 is a root, from there we conclude that 4 minus root 5 is another root. As well, since minus 1 minus root 2 is a root, minus 1 plus root 2 is another root. That in a sense, as they mentioned, these four are roots of the polynomial. But we know, since the coefficients are rationals, for sure its conjugate 4 minus root 5 its conjugate minus 1 plus root 2 are also roots. At the end, totally I have 6 roots for the polynomial. Yes, at the end I found that there are 6 roots for the polynomial. I don't know whether these 6 are the only roots or not. Okay, so finally we have 6 roots for the polynomial. Then from there we conclude that the least degree of the polynomial is 6. Why? Because since it has 6 roots, the degree of the polynomial is 6. Right? It's just simply by fundamental theorem. So, you just observe the task. If the coefficients are rationals, then the roots are alpha plus root beta and alpha minus root beta occurs together. If the coefficients are reals, alpha plus I beta and alpha minus I beta are the roots and they occur together. So this is one simple example and this is another example where we decided the least degree of the polynomial as 6. Okay, have a look. So this is all 17th point, okay. Then I will go to 18th. So just look at the board. Zeros of the polynomial or roots of the polynomial equation are given. Then we need to mention the polynomial as well, polynomial equation. Okay. So if I have a polynomial p of x, then p of x is equals to 0 is the polynomial equation. And for the polynomial, we call these as the zeros, whereas for the polynomial equation, we call it as roots. First of all, think about the first problem here. As they given, the roots are 2, 3, minus 1. Since the roots are 2, 3, minus 1, so it is very clear that, or you may say, since the zeros are 2, 3, minus 1, what it concludes, if we have a polynomial, since 2 is a 0, p of 2 is equals to 0, p of 3 is equals to 0, and p of minus 1 is equals to 0. Because they are the zeros, they will give you 0 from the polynomial. So it in turn represents that from the factor theorem, so x minus 2, comma x minus 3 and x plus 1 are factors of p of x. See, already we discussed it in many cases, okay? Are the factors of the polynomial p of x. Since they are the factors of the polynomial p of x, we will write that the polynomial p of x is x minus 2 into x minus 3 into x plus 1 into, since they are the factors, so into some q of x we need to maintain. Depending on the degree of p of x, we will decide q of x, okay? Since we don't know about the degree, you just write the polynomial p of x as this, x minus 2 into x minus 3 into x plus 1 into q of x. And for suppose, depending on the degree, you need to replace that q of x, okay? Okay, yeah. For suppose, if they ask you to mention least degree p of x, least degree p of x. So, if they ask you to find least degree p of x, in the sense, since already third degree is maintaining from these three factors and there is an ambiguity related to the degree of q of x, since they are asking us to find the least degree p of x, then we need to conclude that the degree of q of x is just 0. If the degree of q of x is 0, then the degree of p of x is 3, that will be the least degree. So, since if they ask you to find the least degree p of x, then we will write that the polynomial p of x is simply x minus 2 into x minus 3 into x plus 1 into some constant a. Because we need to maintain, we need to write least degree p of x. That means we need to maintain a 0 degree q of x. Okay. So this is least degree p of x. And for suppose if they ask you to find least degree polynomial equation. Okay. If they ask you to write least degree polynomial equation, or in most of the cases simply they ask you to write polynomial equation, okay? So least degree polynomial equation, or in another way, if simply they ask you to write the polynomial equation, so that is simply nothing but p of x is equals to 0. So writing that p of x is equals to 0 means all this thing is 0, because a is a constant, send it that side, then it will become x minus 2 into x minus 3 into x plus 1 is equals to 0. So according to the question, according to the situation, we need to use all these things. If they ask you to write the polynomial, this is the actual polynomial. If they ask you to write the least degree polynomial, this is the least degree polynomial. And if they ask you to write the polynomial equation of least degree, this is the polynomial equation of least degree. Okay, sometimes they won't mention it as a least degree polynomial equation, but the options or the answer will suggest you to consider this least degree polynomial equation, and from there we need to conclude this as the required polynomial equation. Okay, so just once again have a look. If these are the roots of the polynomial equation, If these are the zeros of the polynomial, then the polynomial or the polynomial equation can be written in such a way. Okay, have a look, and then you just think about the next one. So that's the first problem, and the next thing is you just think about the second bit, where I mentioned the zeros are the roots as -1, 2, 3 plus root 2. Okay, they are the zeros, or they are the roots of the polynomial equation. So in this case, what to say about the polynomial? So simply for the second bit b, the polynomial is again simply nothing but, since these three are the zeros, then I will write in such a way. Okay, x minus 1 into, since 1 is a 0, x minus 1 is a factor, minus 2 is a 0, x plus 2 is a factor, and 3 plus root 2 is a 0, then clearly x minus of 3 plus root 2 is a factor, into q of x is the polynomial, and that is the polynomial actually. And if you need polynomial of least degree, okay, so what I will say, if I need polynomial of least degree, then I need to take that q of x as some, yeah, is it right? Okay. And for example, if I need least degree polynomial over real numbers, the coefficients are reals just, okay? Since the coefficients are just reals and I need least degree polynomial over reals, then in that case, the polynomial is simply like this. Polynomial is this, x minus 1 into x plus 2 into x minus of 3 plus root 2 into some a. This is the least degree polynomial over real numbers. Since it is over real numbers, this 3 plus root 2 won't affect the coefficients of the polynomial. But whereas, if the task is to find least degree polynomial over rational numbers, over rationals, if we need to mention the least degree polynomial over rationals, if the polynomial is over rationals, and since 3 plus root 2 is a root, then for sure you will get 3 minus root 2 as the other, because it is over rationals now. And that's why I will write that p of x is equals to x minus 1 into x plus 2 into 1 root is this, x minus of 3 plus root 2, and the other root is this, x minus of 3 minus root 2 into some constant a. So if it is a polynomial over reals, the least degree is 3, and if it is a polynomial over rationals, then the least degree is 4 here, okay? And that's, this is the polynomial over rationals of least degree. What to say about the least degree polynomial equation? Least degree polynomial equation over rationals. Since they are asking us to find the least degree polynomial equation over rationals, so this is equals to 0, neglect that a, and directly we will write that x minus 1 into x plus 2 into x minus of 3 plus root 2 into x minus of 3 minus root 2 is equals to 0. This is the polynomial equation over rationals. And further we need to simplify. As we know, the product of these two is nothing but x square plus x minus 2. And what you say about the product of these two? The product of these two is simply nothing but x square, okay? 3 plus root 2 and 3 minus root 2, right? Which is simply minus 6x plus 3 plus root 2 into 3 minus root 2. What you say about the product? 9 minus 2 is 7, is equals to 0. Further, if we need, we just multiply these two to write the fourth degree polynomial. Okay, that's the answer. Have a look. So, do you have any confusion related to this? Already we learned it from the quadratic. If the roots are 3 plus root 2 and 3 minus root 2, then the quadratic equation is simply x square minus sum of the roots into x plus product of the root 7. Okay, and the product is equals to 0. Just have a look. Now, just look at the board. Now, the roots are 0, 1 plus 2i and 2 minus root 3. So, directly I will try to write the polynomial equation, okay? Least degree polynomial equation over complex numbers. What you say about the complex? Okay, C in the sense complex numbers. I think you know about the complex numbers, which includes the imaginary quantities. See, since it is a least degree polynomial equation over complex numbers, so the coefficients may be, the coefficients are complex. Okay, since 0 is a root, x minus 0, x is a factor. 1 plus 2i is a root, x minus of this is a factor. 2 minus root 3 is a root, that 2 minus root 3 is a factor. Then I will say that this answer is nothing but x into x minus of 1 plus 2i into x minus of 2 minus root 3 is equals to 0. No problem, okay? You just multiply this, you will get a polynomial equation. The coefficients may be any complex numbers. This is least degree polynomial equation over complex numbers. First, suppose what you say about least degree polynomial equation over real numbers. If they ask you to write the polynomial equation over real numbers, since they are asking us to find the polynomial equation over real numbers, we need to remove these imaginary quantities. So since 1 plus 2i is a root, since the coefficients are reals, 1 minus 2i is the other root. Then for the least degree I mentioned, this is simply nothing but x into x minus of 1 plus 2i into x minus of 1 minus 2i into x minus of 2 minus root 3, and that the product is equals to 0. Just observe it, okay? Since now the polynomial is over reals, 1 plus 2i is a root, 1 minus 2i is the other root, these two will occur together, okay? And this 2 minus root 3 won't affect the coefficients from the reals, okay? That's why no problem. First, suppose if my question is, if my requirement is to mention the least degree polynomial equation over rationals. See, since I need to find the least degree polynomial equation over rationals, then this time I need to eliminate these imaginary quantities as well. I need to eliminate this root 3 type of irrational quantities. Then in such case, my situation is x into x minus of 1 plus 2i into x minus of 1 minus 2i into x minus of 2 minus root 3 into x minus of 2 plus root 3 is equals to 0. So just to understand the situation, just to analyze the situation, here I am mentioning all the things, okay? Over complex, over reals, over rationals, everything I am mentioning. But to solve the problems, you will face any one of them and you will answer that accordingly. And in the same case, no need to write like this, okay? Directly you have a chance to write it as a multiply these two and write directly, no problem. So the next step of it is x into, we need to multiply these two. So 1 plus 2i is a root, 1 minus 2i is a root. What to say about the product? It's a quadratic equation. So x square minus sum of the roots. Sum of the roots is 2. So 2x, okay? And then product of the roots. 1 square plus 2 square is 5. So plus 5. This is the product of these two. Into what to say about the product of these two? X square minus, again sum of the roots is 4x, plus product of the roots, 2 square minus root 3 square, 4 minus 3 is 1, plus 1 is equals to 0. So this product is simply now the required least degree polynomial equation over rationals. And if they ask you to mention the least degree, you just give it as 5, okay? If they ask you to write the equation, write it in such a way. Have a look.